What is going on, everybody? This is Yasharetha, and today I'm reviewing How to Win Friends and Influence People by Dale Carneggie. Alright, first of all, everybody, I wish you all Merry Christmas and I hope you have some nice holidays. I kind of want to apologize because I haven't been doing videos as regularly as I want, but honestly, between college and work and my personal life, it's been super rough to find free time to read and, to make these videos. So, yeah, I apologize, but yeah, I didn't even get to watch any other videos or series or anything for a while, so let's hope it gets better in January and, well, we'll see. Anyways, to focus on this book, well, actually, I want to say that I didn't really ever think I would read this book because I always thought this title sounds so superstitious or so weird, and it's one of those self-help books, and I always thought I never want to read this book. But I was also curious and I was wondering how this can become an international bestseller, so I picked it up, I read it, and I actually kind of enjoyed it. But I have to say, first of all, that the title, How to Win Friends and Influence People, it's kind of misleading, because this book focuses not on like the friendship you would have with your close friends, at least I don't think so, but instead more like these business relationships or these shorter relationships that you have. And it also focuses on human psychology, on how you should handle situations. But yeah, I'm gonna get into the content right now, give you a short overview, and after that I'm gonna talk about my likes and dislikes and then give you my score for the book. The content in this book is structured into four different parts. The first part is fundamental ways on how to handle people. And this is, like it says, just fundamentally how to deal with people. It shows you some psychological tricks. It shows you some things that the book claims will never work. It's just improve your social skills. Everything in here is pretty basic, but still interesting to read written out like that, and I think most of it is actually true. The next section is called 6 Ways to Make People Like You. As you can imagine from the title, this doesn't only describe how to deal with people, but how to actually gain appreciation and how to make people like you. This features some interesting psychological tricks again and some interesting insights on psychology, like, for example, people don't want to hear you explain everything, but people like to talk about themselves and what they did. And I think that's something, as I said, that you can use in like a business relationship or where you don't really have that good of a relationship, but once you actually get to know someone better, you know, it needs to go both ways, right? You need to be able to listen and the other person needs to be able to listen too at times. So yeah, the next section is called 12 Ways to Win People to Your Way of Thinking. Now, this is, as the title says, about convincing other people, and it shows you some techniques that you can use, how to convince people, or it shows some things that don't really work when convincing people. So as you can see, it now gets a bit further from the usual friendship and more towards the business cases and leadership cases. And that also gets a lot more clear when the last chapter or last section called Be a Leader, How to Change People Without Giving Offense or Arousing Resentment. Now, the last one was, for me personally at least, the least interesting, but it was still kind of cool to read all these little psychological tricks, and I think it's very interesting. It's a good observation of the human psychology, and I'm gonna talk more about this in my likes and dislikes, but yeah, this about wraps up the content. We have these 4 chapters. I think the first chapter and the second chapter were like really interesting, and they were most what I expected coming into the book, and the last 2 chapters are for leadership, more like business relationships, but still interesting. So let's get into my likes and dislikes. I'll start off with my likes. The first thing I really enjoyed is that this book actually offers a lot of insight into human psychology, and it applies these insights in actual, you know, applicable ways on how to improve your interactions with other people. Now, second, like, I actually kind of enjoyed the book. I think I didn't really expect it to be so dry and, well, dry isn't really a good way to describe it. It's not dry, it's more like so practical and kind of scientific. So it has a theory and it, you know, I didn't expect it to be so, you know, so fundamental in basing everything on human psychology and then saying why a certain way works or why it doesn't. I thought it would be more preachy and more, you have to do this and you'll get friends. But instead, it's actually quite pleasant. And the last thing I enjoyed is that this book uses a lot of practical examples, because the author, Dale Carneggie, actually used to hold talks or lectures, I'm not 100% sure, on this very topic for years before finally writing the book. And so he has a lot of experience himself, and he talked with a lot of people who used these principles that he taught them. So there's a lot of practical experience and a lot of examples are used in this book, and I think that's really cool. My dislikes about the book is the first part can basically be summed up in a really short way. It's basically like, be considerate, be kind, smile, think of how the other person feels, and basically apologize and don't force your points. That's basically it. The thing that I dislike about the book is also, well, first of all, I think that a lot of people could benefit from reading a book like this and from trying to act like it says. I actually do think that way. But I also think that socially, you know, awkward or inept people or whatever you want to call them, and I have to deal with some of them, they don't get any clues at all, and that's the problem, and I don't think this book can fix them. Like, I've literally had people talk to me for half an hour about a topic I wasn't interested in at all, and they did not get that I wasn't interested, they just kept talking. So, my overall score for the book is an 8 out of 10. Overall, I really liked it. I think it's a very good book, even though it focuses more on the business aspects and not like personal friendships and relationships. It has some really interesting insights into human psychology, and I think if psychology interests you, or if you think that this whole thematic could interest you, then this book is definitely for you. Anybody who ever has problems getting along with other people should read this book, but again, I think people who don't get along with other people don't get this book, like, seriously. For example, I just read the Goodreads reviews of the book because I was very curious what other people thought, and they were pretty split. Some people said it was good, but some of the reviews are devastating. They're like, ah, this book is complete trash and it forces you to fake smile or fake a personality, fake interest, whatever. And in reality, if you want to get along with more people, that's just what you have to do. Sometimes, even if you're right, you just gotta have to suck it up and shut up and listen to the other person, because it's not worth arguing. And I think the points in this book, I think if everybody would, at least to an extent, follow them, then I could get along with a lot more people easier. Then I think you could get along with some people that you don't really get along with easier. And honestly, yeah, maybe you don't like person X, but it doesn't help if you show them in their face that you don't like him. And I think for these kind of relationships, this book really provides great guidance. How to win friends? I'm not so sure. Probably yes, but I think it's more on like the business case or how to improve relationships that have gone bad. So I think for those cases, it has some really valuable advice. And honestly, I can just encourage everybody to read it. I think the book was really good. And as I said in the beginning, I was really skeptical and I didn't think it actually would be good. So yeah, that's my review for the book. If you read the book, make sure to leave a comment and let me know what you thought in the comments below. If you liked the video, make sure to drop a like, and I'll see you in the next video. Till then, bye!